Hey everyone, it's Cannalise, and I'm going to be walking you guys through a day of my life in quarantine. So usually when I wake up, I brush my teeth, I try to eat breakfast, like when I have time, and basically what you see me doing now is cleaning because I come downstairs to clean the house because it's dirty sometimes, so not dirty but messy. And then I would like sweep the whole house and stuff, not much, but okay. Right now I am cleaning up my cat's area. So she has three bowls. The first one is for her food, the second one's for her water, and the third one is for her ham. She has a special bowl reserved for her ham. That's the one right now. As you can see, I'm cleaning it. Sweep the whole house in the morning. I try to wake up my brother so he can help me clean sometimes, but he doesn't help a lot with that because he's lazy and he's always sleeping. Well, I'm done cleaning up that area, so now I'm gonna move on to my next chore. Oh, I'm putting away the dish. Okay, so right now I'm just trying to film through another angle. At first it was going great. I was like, okay, this is good, but as you see my cat in the background popping. Okay. But then, next you know, I just try to put something where it belongs, and then, bam, a cup fell, and it broke. And my parents, my mom, and yeah, that's when she like came home, and I was like, oh snap, please, I didn't know what to do. It was like glass everywhere and I didn't know how to clean it up. I don't know whether you use a rag or not or something, I don't know. Right now, I decided to grab a broom and started sweeping the counter because it was glass everywhere, little pieces of glass. And as you can see, the people in the background, they were a bit concerned, but it's okay. It was just like a little shots glass cup. No one drinks, it's just, we just have it. Like, I use it for like, to put like honey mustard and like sauce, dipping sauces. Like in the afternoon of the day, I help my mom cook. So we are preparing, I forgot what this dish is called. It's a Puerto Rican dish. It's called, I think it's called bacalao. It's like, it has something to do with fish. I didn't get the clip on here of me making the fish because it was too long and something was going on. So, as you can see, I'm just doing, oh. This is the final product. That orange stuff is like fish and like it's in like sauce and oil. There's eggs, there's spam. Well, that's my plate. The first one was my mom's because she likes like a lot of stuff on hers. I just like mine's a little bit simple. So I don't like the fish. I just don't like fish in general because I think it's a bit gross, but everything else was really good. And I'm trying to record something.
You're not recording nothing.
I'm recording my voice.
Hi.
Can you leave, please? Oh, gosh. Sadi, excuse me. I'm in.
Can you call me when it's
on? Yeah, go. Bye.
Huh?
Yes, bye.
So I'm going to leave this computer.
Okay, peace.
Close the door.
Johnny, call me. Close the door. Sorry, I had to lock my little sister out of the room because I'm trying to film a video and it got interrupted. Like always. But yeah, my quarantine that is it for my quarantine video. I hope you guys liked it. Bye.
Hey guys, it's me TJ, and today I'm going to be doing a trivia. This trivia is going to be about Thanksgiving. Now I know what you're thinking. TJ, Thanksgiving was last week. What are you talking about? Well, it's never too late to do a trivia about Turkey Day, or that's what I like to call it. So let's get started. Question number one. How long was the Thanksgiving celebration? A, 2 days, B, 3 days, or C, 5 days? If you said 3 days, then you are correct! This question is for the NFL fans. When was the first Thanksgiving NFL game? A, 1954. B, 1946, or C, 1920. If you answer C-1920, then you are correct. Happy late Thanksgiving, and I hope you enjoy these two short trivia questions.
Thomas, I'm a council member at large in the city of Philadelphia. The first thing we have to do is look at crime and not just call it one big pot. I think the starting point is gun violence. We have to look at the gun violence issue in the city of Philadelphia as a separate issue. We do have to change the gun laws. Unfortunately, that's not something we can do on the city council side. We also have to look at the issue of poverty, right? Gun violence and crime is a symptom of people who are living in poverty. And until we address the issue of poverty, we're going to continue to see the crime issues that we have. We had a poverty issue before the pandemic. The pandemic hits, and now not only is the poverty issue magnified, which in turn magnifies the crime issue, the city now has a financial deficit. Virtual learning has showed us is that we have disparities as it relates to how people are being educated right now. You need to teach the same lesson multiple ways so that children who learn different ways can receive the information. We got a lot of students that's at a disadvantage. So if we were to give a standardized test, right, and then punish or reward people based on the results of that, well, we can already guess who's going to do well and who's not going to do well. You know, the people who have stable conditions and access to the internet, and also people who are able to learn, right, based on the theory of multiple intelligence is based on how they receive information. You should be interested in what we have to say because the decisions we make impact your life. What we decide, what we do, the rules, how resources are allocated, all that stuff directly impacts your life. So that's the first reason why you should definitely listen. But the second reason is why you can't vote right now. The day will come when you can vote. And hopefully you'll spend a lot of time looking up candidates and knowing who to vote for. And that process is much easier if it's something that you already started prior to stepping in a position to be able to exercise your right to vote. So I think it's important to recognize, again, that decisions elected officials make impact your everyday life. So yes, you should pay attention to who we are and what we say. But then also, again, recognize that the ability to vote is going to come soon. It's right around the corner.
Thank you.
surprised that she was taking us to an island full of them.
If you got a problem with me, just say that.
You know what? I do have a problem with you, Delilah, if that's even your real name.
Are you trying to accuse me of something?
As a matter of fact, I am.
Turns to the group.
Does anyone else find it strange that this random girl we know nothing about suddenly has a solution to all of our problems and claims to know where the so-called island is? I mean, it's ridiculous.
Delilah stands there silently.
Yeah, why are you helping us?
Guys, chill. I think she's just scared like the rest of us.
That doesn't explain how she knows all this information about this place.
I guess it's a crime to help a group of kids that can face death at any time.
Look, everyone needs to calm down. This isn't the time to be arguing about who's suspicious and who's not. Let's just get there.
What if she double crosses us?
You know what?
Lila runs towards JJ and punches her and breaks her glasses. The two girls start to fight.
Hey, break it up or I'll throw you both off the boat.
Dexter and Danny attempt to break up the fight. Danny then punches both Delilah and AJ into the water.
Now, if you guys are done acting like children, we have an island to get to.
You are probably wondering what's going on. Please, hold on. Start about 3 months ago.
Oh,